Hi, and welcome, family. It's so good to see you joining us for the celebration of the season here at the New Beginnings United Methodist Church. Throughout the years, our holiday seasons have been marked by so many great traditions, ways that we have celebrated with family, celebrated with our churches, celebrated in our communities. We're going to talk about a few of those today, so sit back, relax, get ready to enjoy all that is Christmas. Again, it's good to have you here. And we hope that you have a wonderful Christmas season. Happy holidays. Therefore, Israel will be abandoned until the time when she who is in labor bears a son, and the rest of his brothers return to join the Israelites. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they will live securely, for then his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth, and he will be our peace. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Sometimes when we are trying something new, or when we are facing a difficult decision, or when we want to celebrate something, or when we just feel lost and alone and uncertain about life, the universe, and everything, we need a blessing in these times. We don't always think of it in that way or word it like that. We say we need advice or support or companions or someone to come along beside and lift us up again so we can see more than the tops of our shoes. We seek a blessing. For many of us, we go home. We ask mom, we ask dad, or brothers and sisters, close friends, those we grew up with, those who know us best. We want them alongside. We want to be in their presence. Somehow, we know that being there, being home, will make all things better. Maybe it won't be fixed or solved or wished away, but at least we won't be alone. We seek a blessing. Mary, faced with an incomprehensible burden and gift, ran to her cousin Elizabeth's house, looking for someone who knew a little of what she was going through, looking for a place to hide until the reality of her condition could become something real. And she received a blessing. The prophet Micah spoke of a blessing coming to an unexpected place, an unassuming town, yet by God's grace would become the means through which God would bless the whole world. Bethlehem, the little town of blessing. Today, we light these candles, the candle of hope, of peace, of joy, and of love, as a sign that we know that God's blessing is on the way. And we know that waiting for a blessing may be difficult, but we rest assured that all of the promises of God are still yes and amen. We light these candles as a sign that we seek a blessing, and it's time to find our blessing at home in God. Let us pray. Gracious and eternal God, we meet in this space. We join with others around the world who are celebrating the birth of your Son in this season. We extend our faith to celebrate you for all of the many things you have done in each of our lives. We celebrate, God, each of the promises that have come to pass. And we celebrate the hope that we have, knowing that you are still delivering, providing, caring for, sheltering your people. And so on this day, we give you praise and we give you glory, because we believe that they are truly due your name. God, we pray that as we celebrate your Son, Jesus Christ, that you would pour out your blessings of comfort and peace. We remember those who suffered during this season, for those, God, who are going through seasons of bereavement, even through the holidays. We ask, O God, that your Spirit would give them the comfort that they need and soothe even the sin-sick soul. God, bless us as only you can. It's to the glory and honor of your Son, Jesus' name, that we ask these blessings. Amen.
Merry Christmas. My name is Reverend Kiki Wood Terry, and I am the associate pastor here at New Beginnings United Methodist Church. Our scripture reading will come to us from Luke chapter 1, verses 27 through 33. Now listen, this is the word of God. To a virgin, espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom there shall be no end. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Last year, the sultry sound of the silky smooth voice of this brother blessed us for our Christmas special, and he has returned again this year with O Holy Night. Please join us as we welcome Mr. Stevie Wilson.
O Holy Night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Sin and error pining till he appears and the soul felt its worth. A real love hope, the weary world rejoices, or yonder
season. I'd like to welcome our children as they come with their Christmas recitations.
The miracle. Mary in the stable bare laid Jesus in a manger there, wrapped him snugly in the hay, and so began their Christmas day. wise men journeyed from afar, guided by a brilliant star. Shepherds ran to Bethlehem, angels told the news to them. All just wanted to partake of God's sweet plan for Jesus' sake. The crowded in the stable blessed the miracle. God with us.
A bright star, a star shining brightly in the darkness, gave the wise men direction. Set angels aflight, proclaiming God's message. Two shepherds that run to the manger the Savior is born.
They're just my style. They make me happy, at least for a while. But when I'm bored and need something new, shiny and rare or amazing and blue, the only present that brings me lasting joy is Bethlehem, birth of a baby boy.
The Savior of man went too far away. He lived this Christmas and every day.
Don't forget, the city streets are all aglow, but many people have forgotten him, born so long ago. He came to save us from sin and shame, but many people have even forgotten his name. You can turn to him for peace and love, the Christ child who came from heavens above.
I was looking for treasure, shiny and bold. I was looking for treasure, silver and gold. I followed the star and hoped that it led to jewels and money. All for me, I said. I peeked in the door and I saw Mary and Joseph and hay on the floor. I thought I've been had. Where's the treasure, I thought. I came all this way and this is what I got. Then I saw him, the baby, so small. I realized this is the best treasure of them all.
Christ looked behind. Salvation came to earth today, laying down upon the hay. Looking up, he saw her face, Mary, mother, full of grace. Joseph kind was also there, kneeling down in silent prayer. Christ looked beyond, stars so bright, felt Abba Father hold him tight.
Put up your tree and place on it all the trim. Did you leave room for him? When you bought presents for sisters and brothers, did you leave money to maybe help others? When you get involved in all the parties and fun, please take time for the Holy One.
Who gets happy at Coopy? Come kiss me, funny. Who gets down with me?
When the wise men saw the star, I wonder how they knew it would lead them to a king if they kept the star in view. When Herod tried to harm him, did the star refuse to glow, or was it that wicked ambition that kept his gaze too low? I may never follow a star as the Magi did long ago, but I'm glad God leads us wherever he wants us to go.
One day of the year, just one day to celebrate our Savior's Sunday. We can express the joy with faith, love, and peace to all every day with kind words that never cease.
Trust in Jesus, God sent the Christ, who came to earth to free us from our sin, taught us how to live in love, if we place our trust in him.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Oh,
our youth opted to do something a little bit different for their production. Throughout the year, we often have sessions that we call Chat and Chill with the Pastor, where we sit and we have casual conversations and we talk about life, we talk about our belief systems, and we try to get clarity and continue to grow as disciples of Jesus Christ through our dialogue and through our understanding of Scripture. Well, this year for Christmas, the youth wanted to allow you to have a sneak peek into what their Chat and Chill sessions kind of resemble. And so today they want to talk to you a little bit about Christmas and just share some of the thoughts that they have about their fondest memories, the things that are significant to them, and why they think it's important that we take part in celebrating this season with our families and with our churches. Stay tuned and hear what our children and youth have to say about this season in their lives.
Hi, my name is Ashlyn.
Hi, I'm Shelby.
My name is Morgan.
And my name is Simone.
And today, we're going to talk to you about Christmas.
So the first question is, why do we celebrate Christmas?
Because it's all about fun, joyful times with your family, and most importantly, you're also celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ.
And Jesus is...
Our one and only Lord God, our Savior. My favorite memory of Christmas is sitting around the table with family.
My favorite memory is spending time with my family because it's fun and you also get to see all the little kids running around and it's just like so joyful.
My favorite Christmas memory is when I see all the kids' faces light up and everybody just around just talking about how amazing the year's been and stuff like that.
Very favorite memory of Christmas is when I was little, we used to all wake up and open presents at my house and then later go to my grandma's house and all my family be there and she'll have breakfast made and then we'll just sit and talk and fuss about why our toys were better than the other people.
So, we're supposed to be going, for Christmas Eve, we're supposed to be going to eat with the family. And then on Christmas Day, we unwrap our presents, of course, and we're supposed to go to my aunt's house for a family gathering.
I plan on going to my sister's house to watch all the babies unwrap their gifts.
Christmas Day, I'm gonna go eat at everybody's house.
I think I want to spend my Christmas with family, friends, and all of us. I don't know what I'm going to do, but
I'm going to find
something. It's sad because, like, Christmas Day, it may be fun for you, but it's also sad for others because, especially for parents that are less fortunate and they don't get to buy their child like gifts, a lot of gifts. And also like they don't get to give the child, like their child things that they wanted. But also I feel like some children, they don't know what their parents are going through, but some parents just try to just make the best out of it.
I feel like, It hurts more for some families because last year you never know what position they could have been in. And some parents are in the best positions 1 year and then things can change so quickly. And it just hurts some people deeper than others because they always feel like, well, what did I do to get to this point that I am now? Where they can't provide for their family themselves and they're still trying their hardest to do as much as they can. So, and I try to help out my best way possible. Like when I go to the store and I see like the toys for tots things, I always try to donate or something.
I think that's really important because the whole meaning and celebration of Christmas is in a time when we couldn't save ourselves, when we couldn't rescue, redeem ourselves, God gave Jesus. And it was about giving that hope and that opportunity when we couldn't get it for ourselves. And so, what does it mean to celebrate Christmas in a way that shows that same kind of love and care for other people in the world?
That's why I feel like
people should try to come together with their family and enjoy it. But the people without homes and got kids, they're sad too because, like, they can't enjoy it. Like, they don't have a home. They don't have a place to live. They don't have presents for their kids. And usually, like, people, like, the people that, like, live in hotels and stuff, they try their best, like, and got kids. They are probably 9 out of 10. They try their best, like, for their kids and stuff because they don't have it like others got it.
If I was a child with no family or anything, I want somebody to say that they could take me in because I wouldn't want to be by myself by holidays or anything because that's just miserable.
I would say the person who I feel the most connected to, because there's always that person, I would love for them to at least, like, you know, some words of encouragement, like, I'm proud of you, or you're doing a good job right now, or, you know, some people even do the smallest things, like, try to do your hair for you, or just offer you a meal to make you feel comfortable, like, you're in a comfortable environment for once, going through the things that they have to go through. Like,
I want them to talk to me about, like, keeping my faith up and stuff, and don't let anything discourage me, because at that moment, you could feel like you're alone. And
keep pushing through life.
We made it this far. Don't let next year break you down.
I would say, like, thank you for just sticking with everybody, because it's people that come to church and you don't see what they go through, but they don't show that, because sometimes when pastors say, oh, if you have any prayers or anything you want to say, some people don't stand up and they're going through the hardest time that's possibly in their life. So just pray for everybody. Don't pray for one particular person. Pray for everybody, because it's people that come to church. Always have, like, always just nice. Always just so powerful. Just all smiling and everything. But behind closed doors, they always, like, just sad and stuff. Keep your head up and don't let nothing get you down.
So we come to church to rejoice on what God has done for us in life, and we think about what we could do to make our life unsinful for ourselves. Church is supposed to be a safe place.
Supposed to be, like, really welcoming and just a big community just ready to spread the gospel and, you know, like Shelby said, like, a safe place, and we don't have to be afraid.
Church has to be like a new beginning, as I say, as something may happen during that week that we may not know how to, you know, function or something, and we come to church and we may feel brand new and give us a new head start for the next week, you know?
I think church could be like a second home, and it should be like a second family.
So today I want to talk about something that seems very significant, but that also can be a very small adjustment for a lot of us during this holiday season. It's a shift in our mentality. Many of us have heard the mantra, keep Christ in Christmas. Well, the truth is that Christ lives in each of us. Christ lives in our hearts after we welcome God in. And so, candy canes can't take Christ out of my Christmas. Christmas trees can't take Christ out of my Christmas. Santa Claus doesn't take Christ out of my Christmas, because Christ is in me. And that's the reason why I celebrate. And so however you come together with your family, with your community, or in your church, you keep Christ in Christmas by keeping Christ as the center of your celebration. However you decide to do it, enjoy yourselves, love on somebody, and remind the world that the greatest gift that we've ever received was born in a manger in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Merry Christmas from your New Beginning Church family. I'm the Reverend Dr. John Baldwin II, broadcasting here from the New Beginnings United Methodist Church, located at 2133 32nd Avenue North on the north side of Birmingham, Alabama. It's been a blessing to have you joining with us today, and we pray that this holiday season is one where you keep Christ in Christmas and you receive the many blessings that God has for you. God bless you, and we look forward to connecting with you soon.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on a sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering the simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. So I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.